A data type, or simply type, defines the type of data that the attribute or variable will hold, and the operations that can be performed on the attribute or variable in concern. For example, in the transaction book, the attribute book copies available will store numeric values, and we can perform arithmetic operations on the same. A domain is a developer-defined data type that can be shared by several attributes and variables. For example, the attribute student name in student transaction and book author name in book transaction will hold human names. Both attributes are essentially the same type. Therefore, we can declare a domain of variable character type with up to 40 characters and assign this domain to both the attributes. This way, it will be easier to update all attributes that hold human names should we decide to make changes at a later stage. To understand this, let us create a new transaction to record information about the books that have been borrowed from the library. We know that we have assigned an ID of up to 4 digits to all transactions. Therefore, it makes sense to create a domain of numeric type for ID. To create a domain, we type the name of the domain, followed by equal to sign, and then the type of the domain, which will be numeric of 4 digits in this case. When we press the Enter key, the domain is saved. To see the list of all domains, click on View and then click on Domains. This list also contains predefined domains. At a later stage, if we wish to update all attributes that share this domain, we only have to make a change here and the changes will be propagated to all attributes that share this domain. We can now assign this domain to the identifier attributes of all transactions which have similar data type. In the borrowed books transaction, we continue to specify the attributes that we wish to record for the books that will be borrowed from the library. Click on Run Developer menu and navigate to the transaction page. GeneXus automatically assigns labels to attributes in the transaction. It does this by trimming the name of the transaction from the attribute. In this form, the first two attributes have been assigned the same label. To avoid confusion, we will change the label of the first attribute. Click on the attribute and press F4 to view its properties. In the contextual title property, enter serial number and then click on Run Developer menu. Navigate to the transaction to see the changes taking effect. We will now enter a record for the transaction.